All right, home sweet home. How's everybody doing tonight? Oh my gosh, this is beautiful. There's people here. My name is Patrick Logan. I am filling in for Jacob McFadden tonight. Let's make some noise for Jacob McFadden and home sweet home. Hell yeah. We've got two crowd members tonight. We have Ash and Lainey. Say hi, Ash and Lainey. Thank you for being here. It is Lainey, right? Okay. Be nice to them, and you can be mean to anybody you want. If you don't like it, you can boo. That's what Jacob would say. If you do like it, haha. This bathroom, you can use this bathroom, but if you queef in there, we will hear it. You put the microphone up to it. That's what it sounds like if you queef in there. Yes, this is a comedy from home. This is an open mic, one of the longest open mics in Richmond going. It's been going a really long time. The host is usually Jacob McFadden, so I'm going to do a joke in honor of Jacob. My friend told me that I should get a Jacob's Ladder. Y'all know what that is? One of your favorite movies? I haven't seen that one. Judd has. He's gay. All right. So if you don't know what a Jacob's Ladder is, it's multiple piercings down a man's private parts, and they're stacked like a ladder. And my friend told me I should get one. I'm like, fuck no. I'm not getting a Jacob's Ladder. I could get a Jacob's Step Stool. I don't know if they make those. If they do, they better be cheaper. It's less material. So if any of you dudes want to step up, I could be your stepbrother. All right. I went to visit my parents. I feel like I was in better shape when I lived with my parents because my mom, she would always get me to run to the garage a million times. And every time I get back in the recliner and I'm ready to relax, she's like, oh, I forgot something. I need you to run back to the garage. Very forgetful. Not as forgetful as my dad. He forgot he had a kid. Let's see. Trying to get in better shape. Ate some keto cereal. Zer, you ever had keto cereal? Not good? Yeah, it sucks. But the name is accurate. It tasted like keys and toes. It was the keys part that I didn't really like. I suck toes. All right. Let's see. I was born a man. I identify as a man. Not much of a man. I try to do manly things. I can't. But if my car breaks down with a flat tire, I can change the windshield wiper blades. We'll have a clear view out of the windshield while we wait on my mom to come change the donut. I have a fat gay friend. He came out of the closet and ran straight into the pantry, that fat son of a bitch. I want to shout him out so bad, but he'd be pissed. Y'all know his name. Shout him out. Brian. One of y'all got it right. Who said Brian? Who said Jacob? Jacob's not fat. He is gay though. All right. I don't know if y'all have seen this. Y'all know what they say about if a man eats pineapple? Do y'all know this, Lainey or Ash? If a man eats pineapple, so you're not a man. Thank you for clarifying. I was wondering. No. They say if a man eats pineapple, it'll make his semen taste really good. So I've been eating pineapple all day. And I gotta tell you, Lainey, it doesn't. Now my friend, all he eats is chicken tenders and pizza, and his tastes just like pineapple. It's weird. I am a single man. I matched with a girl recently on a dating app. She's like, I've seen you do comedy. Did you do comedy at Busky Cider? And I was like, yeah. She's like, did you have a bit about therapy and depression? And I'm like, no. But if you saw a guy talking about eating his own cum, that was me. Or Jacob McFadden. Or Chris Sipple. I like Shy Girls. Shy Girls. Shy Girls make some noise. Yeah. The cute thing about Shy Girls, if you hook up with a Shy Girl, she'll be like, turn the lights off. And I'm like, I want to see you. I don't want to turn the lights off. She's like, turn the lights off. And I'm like, hey, you're beautiful. You have nothing to be ashamed of. And they're like, turn the lights off. And I finally realized they want me to turn the lights off so they don't have to see me. I don't look this good naked. But with the lights off, I am Jason Momoa. All right. And that's probably why she calls me Jason. All right. Chivalry. I like to be a chivalrous man. Ladies, I don't know if you know this. All these fellas should know this, but it's actually a chivalrous thing for men to walk closer to the road. If you're on a date and a man lets you walk closer to the road, kick him to the curb. Because it is our job as men to walk closer to the road because we have to protect our women from other women drivers. It is dangerous out there. If you like that advice, I'm writing a book. It's called How to Make Women Calm Down. Chapter number one, you can't. Chapter number two, you can try. Chapter number three, refer back to chapter one. Chivalry's not dead, but you might be if you let your woman drive home. All right. After all this, I do want to be vulnerable with you guys. I matched with a girl this week on a dating app, right? Set a date, a time, a place, right? Locked it down. And she told me, she's like, Patrick, I really want to see your stand-up comedy. Where can I find it? And I was like, hey, I'd rather get to know you as a person first, right? Because my jokes don't reflect who I truly am. And when I sent that to her, she sent back, already found it. And I was like, what do you think? You like it, right? And this is what she said back. Should have pulled my phone out first. All right, I'm gonna start that whole joke over. I matched with a girl on a dating app. And she's like, I really want to see your comedy. And I was like, no, just get to know me first. She's like, I already found it. And this is what she texted. I'm gonna be honest. I'm not down with the jokes you're making. Seems like punching down in some low-hanging fruit. You seem very kind and nice, but I'm gonna skip dinner. And I was hurt. So I responded, hey, I understand. I appreciate the input, but I don't take advice from women. And I've seen your pictures. You are not skipping dinner, let's be honest. Low-hanging fruit, you should eat some. You wouldn't look like that. And she wasn't even fat, so that really hurt her, you know what I'm saying? No, I'm just kidding. I didn't send that back, but I did send her back, hey, I understand, but you should really check out my new book, How to Make Women Calm Down. And I went out with a bang just like I wanted to. Hell yeah. Just killed that. All right, I'm going to do 40 more minutes. All right, just kidding, guys. This is Comedy from Home Sweet Home. I'm Patrick Logan. Let's make some noise for your first comedian. I feel like this is a little too loud. Well, no, maybe I'm just loud. All right. Your first comedian walked here from Antarctica. Let's give it up for Mike Marr. Mike Marr's down, man. He's been to a lot of black open mics. I've seen him there. Your next comic, never been to a black open mic. No, I'm just kidding. Your next guy is Mike Marr from the past. Let's give it up for James Copeland, everybody.
That's true. And now that I know exactly how my life is going to turn out, I think I'm going to go ahead and kill myself, guys. No, let's give it up for Mike. Woo! Let's give it up. Guys, I saw a Ford Explorer the other day. It had a novelty plate on it that just said SUV 4x4. That's not a novelty. That's just a fucking label. That'd be like if I was wearing a shirt that said depressed white guy small balls. Like, you're not getting any new information from that, you know? Guys, not everybody knows the PC terms for everything. Like, I was talking to a friend a while ago, and he referred to my wife as an Oriental. I took him aside. I was like, hey, man, you can't say that. Oriental only refers to objects. If you're talking about a person, it's Asian. And he was like, oh, well, Oriental should still apply since you got married to a Sailor Moon body pillow. Just kidding, guys. I married a human. It's not legal yet. Guys, I don't have too many accomplishments in my life, but I think I have more than the people that hang up jigsaw puzzles on their wall. Just the people have so little going on that they buy a jigsaw puzzle, buy a frame, spend one afternoon, and then have a new piece of artwork for the living room. Right in between their dare to avoid drugs certificate and their employee of the month runner-up at Wendy's. It's like submitting Mad Libs to a literary review, guys. All right, guys, I got married 2 months ago. Thank you. My dad gave a speech at my wedding. He was like James when he was in high school. He was in marching band. He learned how to juggle and ride the unicycle. Afterwards, I had to go up to him. I was like, Dad, you're making me look like a nerd. I'm trying to get laid tonight. Thank you. Guys, the wedding dress is traditionally white. It's a symbol of purity. But I thought it'd be more accurate if my wife's dress was like the color of a yellow treasure map with some blood smeared on it. Because that's what our mattress looks like after 8 years of period fucking. You know, me and my wife are not that traditional. Like, she did not change her name when we got married. But I did change my name to James Beta Cuck Rogers. Yeah, it's a family name, so, you know. Before the wedding, we gave my grandmother-in-law a tour of the house. But when we walked by our bedroom, my wife closed the door and she was like, oh, you don't want to see in there, it's dirty. Afterwards, I went up to her. I was like, what are you talking about? We just cleaned. And she was like, oh, I didn't want my grandma to see that we were sleeping in the same bed. I was like, we've been living together for 5 years. Does she think we have two twin beds? Like, we're the parents from Leave It to Beaver? Either we're having sex or I'm gay. Either way, we're going to hell. Guys, my wife makes a lot more money than me. Some people ask me if that makes me feel emasculated, and I always say no, of course not. The only time I feel emasculated is when she calls me Jessica while she pegs me up the ass. Some nods up front. Thank you. She's just agreeing with the premise. She's like, you know what, that is a good time to feel emasculated, yes. Thank you. Guys, I use two search engines primarily. I use Google and DuckDuckGo, but I use them very differently. Like, the last thing I Googled was Israel ceasefire. The last thing I DuckDuckGo'd was fat slut ass fuck. Yeah, you gotta stay informed and entertained. I do watch a lot of gay porn, though. I'm not gay. I just like supporting an industry that's 100% controlled by men. Yeah, we have that and vape shops. Thanks, guys. I'm James.
Woo! James Copeland loves period sex. Hell yeah. His hat, his beanie used to be white. That man's putting in work. All right. Your next comic will never stop being white. Let's give it up for Judd Howard.
Woo! Hell yeah, thank you, home sweet home. It's cold in here. Yeah. You can tell it's cold in here by the tiny little thermometer on the front of Mike Mars pajamas. And James Copeland, y'all give it up for James Copeland. What a wonderful guy. He kind of looks like if Where's Waldo just never got found. He even had like the little dumpster fire gloves. Like, he should have been sitting around like a trash fire or something. All right, let's go to some topical reference everyone will get. Kendrick Lamar said that white comedians can't talk about black women. It's okay, I used to date a girl. Okay, hold on. I used to fuck a girl named Lakeisha. People were surprised to find out that my cousin's name is Lakeisha. You would get that joke if you knew I was from Alabama. My fat ex-girlfriend just started selling drugs. Now I have a big X the plug. Y'all remember getting those weird ass scoliosis checkups in church? Yeah. Y'all got those? Yeah, dude, I got checked for scoliosis like twice a week. Oh, damn. I'm like, damn, Pastor Doug. I'm the one that might have scoliosis. Why are your pants off, dude? Church is the only place you can get blessed and molested. We call that getting blessed. What about those red wax lips they used to give you? Y'all ever get those? The red wax lips? Like it was just red 40 and candle wax? Like, I don't know if they were like a toy or food, but one of my friends told me, he said, as long as you got these things in, you can't do anything gay. It's like a force field. So we would do stuff, you know, that was pretty, it wasn't gay. But if you saw us, you'd probably think it was gay. But we had those red wax lips in, man. My youth pastor was a weird dude. I don't always take a tub bath, but when I do, I jerk off in it. I just like seeing it float around. I just like swishing the water around and look at it dance. I told somebody, I was like, you ever given anyone a frosted turd? And he was like, what's that? And I was like, it's when you have a turd covered in cum. And he was like, that's disgusting, dude. Why would I jerk off in the toilet? I'm from Alabama, so I know this person in Alabama, and they use the word poems. It's like, come on. You're from Alabama. You don't say poems. You're from Alabama. You do shit like my parents used to tell me, if you blew the pubic hair off the toilet, you get a wish. I don't really like pubic hair, but I do deal with it. I deal with it like a redneck would. I take it and I just pack it into my lip. And then when everything's over with, I just kind of like reach in there and just draw it out, just like a good old dip of tobacco. I quit drinking like 4 years ago. I quit drinking because I can't hold my liquor. If I take like 4 shots of Jaeger, I'll eat out anybody. Liquor goes in, my liquor comes out. I was hooking up with this chick one time, and I was gonna go down on her, and I pulled out a foil pack, and she said, "Oh, you're such a gentleman." Damn right, I'm a gentleman. This is a pack of ramen noodle seasoning, creamy chicken, and yes, I say ramen. That is how it's pronounced. R-A-M-E-N, Ramen Noodles. Y'all give it up for your host. Yeah.
Yeah. I love Judd. His jokes are like, this is how Judd writes jokes. He's like, I ate a red piece of acid. They call me Trippy Red, you know what I mean? God damn it. If you like him, you're going to love your next comic, guys. Give it up for the most energetic person I've ever seen that's not on cocaine. If he is on cocaine, why didn't you offer me, you son of a bitch? Give it up for Will Miner.
Yay! Yay! Keep it going for me. I don't share my He looks like he owns a vape shop. I can't trust that guy. Come on. And keep it going for Judd, everybody. Come on. Yeah. He likes to jizz on poo. He's a very brave man, although I think Judd is from the country. Apparently he was raised in the barn, didn't close the bathroom door. Where did he go? That slut. Where is that whore, Jensen Howard? I was going to shame him for not shutting the bathroom door. I know he's raised in a barn, Jesus Christ. And I know what you all are thinking. Finally, some feminine energy on this stage. It's about goddamn time, right? Get some women energy up here, okay? I admit it, okay? I'm not a woman, but I do have long hair, I've got wide hips, and my nipples are so hard right now I could breastfeed a baby. I am so terribly chilly. What the hell happened? For God's sake, someone warm me up a ginger ale. Okay, let's get into some jokes. Let's tell a jokey poo. How's it going, everybody? We all drive here. I rode my bicycle here tonight. Any other bikers?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, one brave person. Everybody else is upset at us. Ah. I feel like we're on bikes right now and they're on cars passing us. Fuck you guys, that's A-okay. You know, it's funny. I always get the same look. You always get the same look whether you're riding your bike to a bar or whether you're riding your bike away from a bar. People just look at you and they're just like, That guy definitely has a DUI. Okay, a bunch of people who don't have DUIs. Wow, high and mighty. Why don't you all drink and drive and go home? On your cars. I'm gonna get wasted and fall off my bike. That'll show all of you. I'll scrape my knee and think of each and every one of you. For those of you who don't know me, I'm also an Eagle Scout. I am an Eagle Scout. Do you all know what that is? You all know the Eagle Scouts? The few, the proud, the molested, the Eagle Scouts? Woo! Guys, I'm kidding. I wasn't molested. My butt was too big. Really showed those Scoutmasters. They were just like, ah, how do we get around him? This 12-year-old, this weirdly big ass. Ah, come here. They couldn't get me. Does anybody know how to become an Eagle Scout? Anybody know how to become an Eagle Scout? Besides being molested? Come on. Okay, this guy, hey James, you're back. Thank God, you know how to shut a bathroom door. Yes, indeed, you gotta do a community project. For my community project, I sold fentanyl. Thank you. Yes, one person likes fentanyl. They ride their bike and they enjoy fentanyl. Hell yeah. We're gonna hang out after the show, do all the blow I was gonna share with Patrick. Whether you like it or not, I had an impact on the community. They were definitely talking about the 12-year-old who was selling fentanyl. People were talking. It was a pretty big deal. All right, enough about that. Anybody like musical theater?
Yeah.
Any fans of musical theater out there? Clap it up if you like musical theater. Getting some nods up here. Hell yeah, bald friend, you like musical theater, bud? Yeah. Hell yeah, that's a good answer, dude. I think the power of musical theater can solve anything. I think any problem can be solved through the power of musical theater. For instance, Israel-Palestine. No, hold on, just go with me, you know, instead of West Side Story, West Bank Story. Hey, hold on, I gotta find the tune. When you're a Jew all the way, from your first matzo ball to an IDF raid. You're never alone, you're always being watched, hey, come on. It's musical theater, guys, we're gonna solve it. Boy, you look just like those Palestinians. I was trying to do an open mic in Gaza. They're like, please leave. I forgot where I was going with that next one. That's A-okay. We'll come after it on top. God damn it, what was my next bit gonna be about? Bryce, be a lamb and pick up my notepad next to you, bud. What's the last word on that notepad say?
I think it says mosque.
Mosque, oh nice. I should definitely do my mosque bit after that killer Palestinian joke. That would definitely round out the group. Do you all want to hear my mosque bit? Do you want to hear it?
Yeah.
You want me to do the mosque bit? Okay, I can do it really quickly. It's actually just about, I had a really great experience. I had the chance to go to a mosque. One of my best friends is Palestinian. He wanted me to come with me into mosque with him. And it was a really cool experience. And I gotta say, if anybody hasn't been to mosque before, are there any Christians in the audience? Are there any Christians or Catholics? Okay, guys, holy shit. Mosque is just like a Christian mass. It's the same thing. It's just like a big game of Simon Says. Like, if you've never been to mosque before, it's the exact same thing. Everybody gets shoulder to shoulder with one another. The imam gets up on stage and he's like, Allah says everybody kneel, so everybody would kneel. And then he says, Allah says everybody stand up, so everybody would stand up. And then he pauses and he goes, everybody kneel. And then one guy would kneel and he'd be like, I didn't say all I said. Oh, God is great. God is good. See, that was totally worth ending on. Alrighty, I'm gonna go do some blow. Thank you, Patrick Logan. I love all of you.
Will Miner, give it up for him one more time. Let's give it up for him. I don't really get into politics. I don't get into it. Honestly, to me, it doesn't matter where you stand on Palestine and Gaza. As long as you're not standing in Gaza, that would be unsafe. That would be... No, I'm just kidding, guys. Are you ready for your next comic? Are you ready for your next comic, guys? Make some noise for Mr. Christopher Sipple Joyner.
As Anthony said, the Confederate flag is on the moon. I fight for the American flag. That's right, I'm in the military, just at a part-time level. I believe we're protecting the country at a part-time level because I value my time more. I was Black Friday shopping, and I ended up buying socks, and it made me remember how like I started out jerking off, that I started with no-show socks. And then as I got older and larger, I went with crew socks. And now that the age that I'm at now, I just buy high socks to make myself feel better. Thank you for the sympathy with that. I'm proposing to my girlfriend this month of 4.5 years. And over Thanksgiving, no, don't clap for that. That's the end of the that's the end of the world for me. I went to see my dad. My dad's a hardcore Republican Christian. I went to see him for Thanksgiving, and my dad was talking to me. He was like, you know, son, when are you going to propose? And I was like, well, you know, actually, I just actually am going to next week. And he was like, ah, finally, I thought you were gay. And I was like, no, dad, I'm not. I'm marrying a woman. And he was like, well, she better carry our last name, my last name. And I was like, dad, that would make me gay if I did that. So I'm going to hyphen it. I am a YouTuber. I'm an automotive YouTuber. I do YouTube series builds. And speaking of a father, I did a video series on how do you build a car if you never had a father. The number one watch video on that series is how do you hold a flashlight if you never had a father? My dad commented and he said, that's not how you do it. So my parents divorced. Eventually, my mom did remarry. For my stepfather and my mother, they went to we all went to Vegas for them to get married. And my stepfather took me to a strip club with his two friends for a bachelor party. And he bought me a lap dance. It's not the weird part. The weird part was that it was my mom that came out performing the lap dance, guys. That was the weird part. No, that's the made up part. The real part is, we walked into the strip club, and I said, I'm 21, and I'm not spending any money because I'm broke. So the strippers, of course, said, hey, don't go to that guy. He's not spending any money. So we all sat at a table with four chairs while three people were getting lap dances, and I wasn't. And I was timing my stepfather because I was like, I've heard him and my mom fuck plenty of times. I know this man doesn't last more than 7 minutes. Stop edging. No, it's, does anybody here have step-parents? You do? There's like a challenge with having step-parents, right? You either want to fight them or fuck them. You agreed, and then you said, whoa, let me catch myself, I'm not going to be honest. They're either beating on your mom or fucking your dad, and you're just like, when is it my turn? This election is over now. We all know all the antics that led up to this big election. Trump working at McDonald's. I just want to think that Trump was made everyone recount the chicken McNuggets, the 10-piece, just like election votes. Kamala Harris, if she were to work at McDonald's, pull the same shift, she would have just been working with everyone she put in prison that's on work release. No, do you remember he said, they're eating the pets. Do you think that he was feeding the pets that they're eating to his customers? That was my answer too. I read that joke and I was like, I don't know. That's the response I wanted. You ever sign up at a job and you get an email that says, hey, want to sign up for a 401k? You gotten those? I never signed up for a 401k because I don't want to do a cancer walk that long. I'll get out of here on this one. Is anybody flying for the holidays? Boeing airplanes? You can't do a knock-knock joke on a Boeing plane because there's no door. I'm a person that likes to learn a little research, do research here and there. I learned that the helicopter that Kobe was on, the propeller that went bad, was made by Boeing. A guy that was in retirement, I fucked that joke up. Rest in peace, Kobe. We'll just end it on this one. I'll have to learn that one. In the military, I do a lot of training on helicopters. Before we take off, everybody prays to God, you know, that we come back safely. I just say Kobe's name 3 times. That's my time. Thank you.
Keep it going for Chris Joyner, everybody. Laney liked you, Chris. Laney.
I appreciate it.
Everybody, we all like you. All right, let's do it. What are you doing in there, Ash? No, I'm just kidding. We love you. We thank you for being here, guys. You ready for your next comic?
Yeah.
He's not Chuck Uncle. He's not Chuck Brother. Actually, he is a brother. He's not Chuck Cousin. He's Chuck Nephew, everybody. Let's give it up for Chuck Nephew. Yeah. Keep it going for Chuck Nephew.
Appreciate it. Hey, white girls not having ass, that is a lie. It's a thick ass white girl downstairs right now. She built like a horse. I love thick, big white girls. I love them. You got ass, man? No ass? Okay, that's okay. You remind me of my favorite cartoon character, though. Kim Possible. She was so fat. What? They need to bring them cartoons back. I love some Kim Possible, man. For real. The only thing, you just ain't got the red hair. That's it. That's all, you know. But Kim Possible, I know she had some nice set of titties. You know, they was perky. She never wore a bra because they were so small, you feel me? But I know she had them milk dub nipples, though. You feel me? The milk dubs? I'm telling you. I know she did. Then she had the slim waist. I know she had some ass, though. I know she did because she always wore them baggy-ass capri pants. Yeah, Kim Possible had some ass, man. That's my favorite white girl, man. Y'all don't know about Kim Possible? Man, hey, y'all won't watch a cartoon for real. Okay, how y'all doing, white people? Y'all doing good? Shout out to y'all, man. I love y'all. Love y'all. White people, y'all gotta start whooping y'all kids' ass. Y'all gotta start doing it, man. That's how they become serial killers and shit, because y'all ain't whooping their ass enough, man. All these mass shootings happening and shit, man. I'm talking about one ass whooping will stop 1/3 of the mass shooting. I did my calculations, believe me. I know. But my son, he just turned 4 years old. He had a birthday party. He invited his little white friend over. Her name is Lucy. Lucy came over to my house. I know she ain't never had an ass whooping because she came over my house locking doors and shit. Come on now. In a black household, locking the door would get your ass whooped, white people. I'm just letting you know. Just letting you know. But yeah, then when I walked downstairs to see what was going on, I see Lucy, she tied my little cousin to the tree outside, like with the rope. Like, I'm like, Lucy, get that rope off my cousin. White people, y'all know what the fuck I thought was going through my head. Y'all know what I thought. I said, hey, I don't know what game y'all playing, but take that rope off my cousin, man. The whole thing you're right around here is the pinata, man. Come on now. Get in the house. I love y'all white people, man. I love y'all because y'all follow the rules and shit, man. Y'all obey the rules. White people will wait till the end of the crosswalk and wait till the walking icon pop up. Not black people. Shit. Not us, shit. We playing leapfrog with the traffic. We like Deion Sanders out there. Shit. Fuck that. We don't give a fuck about our life. That's why I love white people, because y'all care.
I tried to party with some white folks before because I thought y'all parties was kind of different. But them shits is different. It's so depressing and gay. I'm like, God damn. I walked in the house one day, man. I walked in that bitch. I see a white girl in the corner. She crying and shit. Her friends comforting her like, it's okay, Lucy. It's okay. She said, no, my cat just died. I said, God, she crying over a cat? What the fuck is going on in here? So, you know, me, shit, I'm the only black person in there. So I just try to, you know, do my thing. Like, I went to the fruit punch. Like, shit, let me get a bowl of punch or something. I was like, fuck it, man. I had a one guy, he pulled up right behind me, like, whispering in my ear, like, hey, dude, you want to go smoke some weed? I answered too fast, though. I said, yeah, yeah. Then he said, and measure our dicks. I said, oh, hell no. Hell no, I don't play them games. I'm like, why be measuring my dick with you, man? I do that anyway, like. Fellas, do y'all measure y'all dick? When the last time y'all measure y'all dick? Oh, it's been a while, huh? Y'all remember them Comcast remotes and shit? The black and white remotes? The old janks. Y'all must have had Comcast then. But them shits was long and thick. Yeah. I'm like, yeah, I'm about the size of this remote right now. Okay, yeah. I'm looking good, ladies. I'm looking good. But nah, man, I'm going to go ahead and get up out of here. I'm Chuck Nephew. I appreciate y'all.
Chuck Nephew, everybody. I love that Chuck mentioned that white people cry when their cats die. Because that's the reason Jacob McFadden isn't here, because his cat died. You son of a bitch. All right, I'm sorry, Jacob. God damn it. I'm sorry. What's his... Okay, hold on. Welp. I forgot his wife's name on camera. God damn it. What's her name? Why am I wondering what Jacob's wife's name is? All right, Silver, delete this shit. I'll remember it by your next comic, guys. I shouldn't know his wife's name. Anyways, your next comic... loves when cats dies. God damn it. I blame me doing bad right now because I didn't retain my semen today. All right, guys. Give it up for Danny McCabe, everybody. No, wait. That was a trick, motherfucker. Your next comic loves cats. Give it up for Bryce T, everybody.
Hell yeah, I love pussy. How y'all doing tonight, home sweet home pimps?
Hey.
How you doing, pimps, inside the camera watching from home? All three of you. My name is Bryce T. Unsweetened Bryce T, the unsweetened pimp. I'm bisexual. I get sexual with people, they say goodbye. Only two people don't know that. It reminds me a lot of home. I feel both abused and neglected up here. In fact, I did not have a good home life. My mom made sure to bully me before anybody else. Like one time I had a bad day at school, right? And I tell her about it. I come home crying. She's like, what's wrong? I'm like, well, I had a bad day at school. I failed a test. I felt really awkward. I sat alone at lunch, and then I walked home in the rain. And when I walked home in the rain, my headphones didn't work. And to make matters worse, when I was halfway home, someone yelled from their car, hey, faggot, and a bottle hit me in the back of the head. And she goes, I'm sorry, but I'm really happy I was loud enough for you to hear that. Gotta hit you before anyone else does. Speaking of whores, y'all into the sex work? Y'all appreciate sex work? Hell yeah, all two of you. Now, I gotta see pussy somehow. I gotta get into sex work, you know what I mean? Like, my friend found out I do enjoy the sex work. He found out I subscribed to a girl's OnlyFans. And he's like, I lost all respect for you. I'm like, I don't give a fuck what you think. I pay $5 to watch your wife fuck other men. And I'm a content creator too. I'm next. I'm excited to be hosting that shit. But man, as you can tell, I'm a crazy guy, man. I say some crazy shit all the time. Like my last relationship, it didn't work. I said something I should have not have said. My girlfriend I was dating called me crying. I said, what's wrong? She says, I feel ugly. I feel fat, and I feel stupid. And I'm like, babe, you're not ugly. She's like, and I'm like, and what? You're dating me, you're some kind of stupid. And I like fat girls, I like heavy set girls. I like my sex to be a lot like my Papa Roach songs, with suffocation, no breathing. You know what I mean, pimp. But like, Super Bowl's coming, you know, it's December, it's getting cold, football's in season, and Super Bowl's coming. I don't know if y'all think a lot about commercials, I love the commercials, but I don't know if y'all remember, Dylan Melvaney, who's a trans person, and he had a sponsorship with Bud Light, a lot of people got upset. And I say we should double down. We should get the corporations into it. Let's have me into a commercial for beer. Imagine me in a commercial, dark room, fireplace lit, and I'm fucking Dylan Mulvaney hard and heavy. And then I hold up a Budweiser and I'm like, Budweiser, tops other beers. I think it's a good going. But man, I do gotta like spice up the bedroom with my life, because as you can see, I'm not the most attractive man up here looking like a 1980s porn star director up here with a leather jacket and shit. But like, my girlfriend, she likes Star Wars, and we decided role play with Star Wars. And she comes out into the room, dressed like Princess Leia, sexy as shit, coming in with a white gown. There I am, butt naked, painted green, supposed to be Yoda. I'm like, blurry you will. Long I will not last. Ride you like Luke I will. Force I cannot use. But like, man, it's cool being a bar and shit. Like, I don't know if y'all know this, but I had to go to court today for a speeding ticket. I've never been to court before. The only court matter I had is when my friend went to court-ordered rehab. The funniest way is how he got to rehab. He was driving home one night, drunk, and he thought the idea of turning off his headlights so the cops wouldn't see him. They see your ass when you crash into the squat car. But like, when he got pulled over, to make matters worse, there was a beer in the car with him. And the cop pulled him over, went up to his window and said, "Sir, have you been drinking tonight?" He goes, "No." He goes, "Then whose beer is this?" He goes, "My friend is drinking it. Unfortunately, he cannot be here tonight. I would like to report a missing persons. My name is Bryce Steve. Thank you for your time. And remember, it's not drunk drivers who are the problem. It's drunk crashers who give us the bad name."
Bryce T, everybody. All right, we're going to keep this thing rolling. Your next comic's been waiting very patiently since I accidentally called his name 5 minutes ago. But he's lucky, because it's his turn right now. And he'll be coming up any minute. But Jacob usually does 30 minutes in between sets, so I'm going to do 30 minutes right now. Does your mom like you? What, Sabet? What? No, I'm just kidding. All right, guys, let's give it up for Danny McCabe, everybody.
Thank you, Sabet, for the intro, and Patrick. Yeah. Now, yeah, absolutely. It's funny, you know, Bryce mentioned sex work. You know, the other day I was actually talking to a sex worker. And, you know, I like to have conversations with everybody. Nothing to be worried about. And, so at some point she got really upset about how when, like, people will call her a slut, right? And I was like, "Well, why is that?" I was like, "Do you mind telling me what, you know, the correct terminology is?" And she's like, "Yeah, you know, it's definitely like escort or like companion or worker." And I was like, "Oh shit, I didn't even know there was such thing as proper pronouns." Boom. All right, let's get this started. Oh shit. Guys, I fucking hate rumors, you know? You guys ever hear any weird rumors about yourselves, right? I I'm here to deny one right now. I was not the guy who stole Woody in Toy Story. It was not me. Jesus Christ. Fuck. It actually happens to be because I suffer from a condition. It affects one in two of every white guy of my caliber. It's called being visually Republican. Yeah, working in a bar, that's also a fun game to play because I call it dog whistle roulette. Because basically, you never know if some guy, old guy coming in is gonna say some wild shit or not, right? And I'm trying to find a way to deter them. And I'm trying to think, you know, we gotta take it to the extreme. Like, you know, we gotta really, like, you know, put like a citronella candle out there for these guys, right? And I think I know what I'm going to do is I'm going to start wearing a big furry tail when I go into work. I think that's the way to do it because, you know, like I'm going to be, you know, hey, what can I get you? And then turn around to the taps and then they're going to say, ah, it's a fuzzy. Yeah. Because, it, you know, to them, you know, you got to be hip to know what a furry is. So they're not hip. You get that. But no, I think that'd be great because I'm going to get it real, like kind of looking actually real. So, you know, they're going to also be wondering, you know, is it a clip-on or a stick-in? Leave it up to the imagination. Shit, you know, let's see, what else we got here? We got a lot of white people in the audience tonight. Yeah, yeah. It's typical for these home sweet homes. You know, I always say, you know, us white people, we're a lot like chain restaurants, like every different type is a type, you know. The guys who are going to say weird things, you know, at the bar, definitely Cracker Barrel. You know, what about you, Patrick? What? Yeah, yeah, let's see. Yeah, yeah. What restaurant are you? What chain restaurant are you, man?
Chili's.
Chili's? Okay, I actually see that. I feel like this guy just causes a ruckus because of like those $3 Apparitas or whatever the fuck. Yeah. Yeah. I see that. No, I've always said that, like, you know, I'm sort of a special one. Like, I'm Kava because, you know, I have a little bit of Middle Eastern heritage. And, you know, you think, oh, wow, that's something different. But really, no, it's pretty whitewashed down there. But hey, you know, it's kind of goes with some other things in life here that, you know, I had this coworker who's been like saying some real weird shit to me. He said, you know, he thought I was Jewish. And I was like, no, I'm not Jewish. And he goes, oh, well, it's because you have a lot of opinions on things. I was like, what the fuck? I was like, I didn't even know that was like a thing. Like, did I just unlock a new part of, like, racism? Like, you know, I felt like I got an Xbox achievement, and, like, I felt really shameful about that. Oh, shit. But if you don't like that, I'll tell you one thing is I've gotten into new hobbies, you know, with winter trying to stay in. I've gotten into bathing. You guys do that out there? Bathing?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I've gotten really into baths, bath bombs. Bath bombs are great. I totally thought, you know, the one that I was using at home, because I kind of had an appliance around the house, would totally sort of give me a shock into this whole new hobby, but it turns out you have to plug the toaster in. It's a slow burn, think about that. Oh, shit. Patrick, how much time do I got left?
Zero.
Zero? Okay, I'm sorry, I just totally missed the light. All right, well, until next time.
Do one more?
Okay, all right, shit. What do you guys call a snake that can't slither? A reptile dysfunction. All right, let's get out of here.
Hey, comics love bath bombs because at least it's warm when you're bombing. All right. Danny McCabe was asking what kind of chain restaurant I... Danny, I think you're actually Olive Garden because you look like a fucking breadstick, dude. In a good way. I love them. They're good. Lynn. I did remember his wife's name, Lynn. I love you guys. I'm sorry. I know it's weird. Just for the record. And your next comic, he is out here tonight getting reps. He took his fucking warm-up jacket off. He is not fucking around. Let's give it up for Zuri Mania!
Damn, how much do you bench?
A lot.
What's going on, home sweet home? How y'all doing?
Woo!
Yeah! It's good to be here. My second time here, home sweet home. Love doing comedy. Every time I do comedy, I surprise people. They look at me like I'm not supposed to be on stage or some shit. Like I'm supposed to be outside. Like I was the bouncer or some shit. I was standing outside earlier, a line forming in front of me. They was like, how much cost to get in? I was like, I don't fucking know. I'm on stage, bitch. Anyway, how was y'all Thanksgiving? Y'all have a good Thanksgiving holiday? Woo! Yeah. I ate everything, man. Every fucking thing. What's your favorite food, man? What's your favorite food? I know y'all like food. Y'all like food? Fried rice. That's different. Well, fuck it. Y'all like fried rice too. All kinds of carbs. You know what I hate about Thanksgiving? Holidays in general, my family. They get mad at me over stupid shit. Like, my grandma got mad at me because I forgot how to play spades. Yeah. Spades, man. People take spades too serious. Like, they act like it's the World Series or some shit. Like, damn, grandma, I didn't know this is the World Series of spades. But okay, fuck it. Anyway, moving on. Next joke. My bad, hold on. All right, moving on. Next joke. Oh, shit. I'm on camera. Hey, what's up, y'all? How many people watching? We live? We live? Oh, fuck it. Well, coming back to the holidays, you ever get a gift you ain't like? Yeah. I got socks last year. I was pissed off, man. Like, damn, socks again? I ain't doing this shit no more. You got to do better next year, Uncle Charles. This is bullshit. But anyway, what do y'all do for a living?
Bartender.
You're a bartender?
AutoZone.
There we go. Are you working AutoZone too? There we go. I got a bunch of jobs, man. I do personal training and I work from home. Everybody work at home, clap. Yeah, I love working from home. You know why? Because I do everything but work. Yeah, I be on Netflix, YouTube, RedTube, Pornhub, all kinds of sites, man. Wasting all kinds of time and shit. Good thing about working from home, you bring your laptop anywhere, move your mouse every 5 minutes, let your people know you still online. I'm the only person that do that shit. All right. No, y'all lying. Anyway, moving on. Like I said, I do other things too. I work out sometimes. I like to pick shit up and put it back down. You know what I'm saying? You know, I do personal training too. You know, people get mad at you when they don't lose weight. Like it's my fault. If I teach you how to do push-ups and sit-ups, you go home, eat cupcake, cookies, and pies. That's your fault. That is not my fault, man. You know, people always make excuses why they shouldn't make it to the gym. I got one client, he come up with excuses all the time why he can't make it to the gym. I don't gonna tell y'all tonight. First excuse he told me, he said he couldn't make it to the gym because he stubbed his toe. His toe. It was arm day. You don't even need your toes, man. You just need your arms, man, so you can do the curls for the girls and get cut from the girls with the nice juicy butts and shit like that. Another excuse guy told me, he said he couldn't make it to the gym because he was stuck in traffic. Yeah, stuck in traffic. I knew he was lying. I was like, all right, man, we be honest with me. Tell me where you at. He said, all right. Since I'm being honest, I'm in the line at Popeye's right now, waiting on my chicken sandwich. Now, I don't know about y'all, but being late to your personal training session with Popeye's is like being late to an Alcohol Anonymous meeting because you had to stop at the liquor store. It's just unacceptable. But since you're at Popeye's, bring me back a 12-piece and we'll let this shit slide. And I noticed something about groups of people, you know? How come certain people get certain traffic privileges? Yeah, certain people get certain traffic privileges. Like, why we gotta wait for the ducks to cross the street? This bullshit, they always making me late for work and my boss never believes me when I gotta go, you know, when I'm not gonna work from home and shit. Boss never believe when I tell him the Duck Dynasty was crossing the street. Duck Dynasty, Daffy Duck, Donald Duck, all kinds of ducks, and that's why I'm late. He's like, get the fuck out of here, you're fired. And Why do funeral processions get to run red lights? What's the rush? He already dead, he ain't going nowhere. And I'm in this shit off right tonight. Just remember them shit. Everybody stick together. What did the left butt cheek say to the right butt cheek? Yeah, together we can stop this shit. Hey y'all, I'm Zuri Mania. I'm out. I'll be at the Funny Bone December 5th, 7 o'clock. Be there or fucking don't. Peace.
Zuri Mania, everybody. I love the idea of his buff ass waking up on Christmas morning in his Christmas PJs, going to look in his stocking sock to get socks and just being pissed. I don't know. That's funny shit to me, man. Seeing you in Christmas PJs mad about socks and socks. All right. Don't get Zuri socks.
Okay.
Thank you, man. I needed that shit. Guys, your next comic. This is his first time ever doing stand-up comedy. It is my pleasure to introduce to you a man of a fellow Pat. Let's give it up for Pat Seavey, everybody. Pat Seavey.
Yikes. Didn't know I'd be following Bernie Jacked. Was wondering where the coke guy was because he had a mustache and that's kind of how I was going to start it. But wow, what a mustache did he have. I tried to grow a mustache in high school, but I was deterred by my mother. And by deterred by my mother, I mean that my mother told me I looked like I was Freddie Mercury but gayer. I wouldn't take that as an insult today, but you go grab a 10th grader who's on the JV lacrosse team and tell me he looks gay, see how it goes, they will not take it well. But yeah, honestly, that might be like a generational thing with facial hair. Like, I know for a fact that if I would have shown up to Thanksgiving in full Nazi regalia, but I was unshaven, first thing, if I walked in, most members of my family would have said like, whoa, dude, what's with the fucking beard? And it really does go both ways. Like, I vividly remember I was 8 years old and I was watching Duck Dynasty with my brother, and my dad was like, how do you guys watch this shit? I was like, what's wrong with them? He immediately goes, terrorists. I looked at my brother, I was like the 9/11 guys. My brother was a dickhead. He was like, yeah, 100%. Fuck. And yeah, so for a good 3 years, I really just thought that I didn't know about 9/11. I thought that terrorists only targeted investment bankers and ducks. And then I learned that I was a snitch too, because I was at the Atlanta airport. There was a guy who kind of looked like you. Behind me, and I was 10 years old, and I was like looking at the TSA guy like, yo, I got one. Get him, we found one. Yeah, you know, maybe they had a point, I guess. Like, if you look at it historically, Hitler, Bin Laden, Stalin, they all had facial hair. Susan B. Anthony, Rosa Parks, Sydney Sweeney, no facial hair. I'm very observant. I notice these things. But no, I really shouldn't poo-poo my parents. Like, maybe I should. They drew weird lines. Like, I vividly remember my mom playing Say Ah by Trey Songz, but the clean version. Like, thanks for taking the profanity out of the song about jizzing in a mouth. But no, I really shouldn't judge. I like to think I was raised right. Like, I used to have a girlfriend. I was a good boyfriend. I never cheated on her. I think I found that, like, there's a difference between dudes who cheat on their partner and dudes who don't. I'm a dude who doesn't. I think that dudes who cheat on their partner, they act as though they've been single, they've been broken up with for like 3 months. You know, they go to bars, they're like, hey, let's go. Party time. I would act as though I had been broken up with for 3 days. You know, like, chips and salsa in bed immediately. Cracking stick in the robe, just grabbing the nearest shirt. Throw it wherever. Didn't really clean it up all the way either because I was going to do it again. All right, what do I do? On YouTube, they say tip your waiters and waitresses. So do that. Thank you.
Give it up for Pat Sibby, everybody. His first time. Stand-up comedy is not easy. Not easy. Hey, come back. Keep it up. Your next comic.
You
didn't have to.
They had beards. So
all right.
Oh, that's like the comparison.
I love watching a gay dude talk to a straight dude about Dunk Dynasty. That was funny to me. Your next comic is a long way from his first time, guys. This guy is a veteran. Let's give it up for him. Kale Daddy Moore!
Hey, don't beat yourself up. My first time performing stand-up, I did it for one person. Because I started stand-up in Montana, and it was in the middle of a blizzard. The only people that showed up were me and the host. I was like, I guess I'll see you next time. And he was like, you don't want to run through your set? big news today. Big news. Did you guys hear about the South Korean coup?
Woo!
Yeah, it was one guy as a South Korean president. He tried to throw a coup and then completely fucked it up. But the really incredible part is that it was completely bloodless. Not a single person got K-popped.
Woo!
In the course of that coup. But still, whenever a right-winger tries to overthrow a democracy, it's a black pink day for the world. Thank you. You two look like the only two who would get K-pop references in this audience, so thank you. Now that's why I feel like this country is fucked. Is because the people with the right opinions are too fucking nice. Like, Trump just says shit like, they're forcibly cutting men's dicks off in prison, and then the Democrats are like, I don't like it, guys, but we have to hear him out. It's like Tim Walz was the most excited I've ever been for any politician because he told the opposition to shut the fuck up on stage. Why don't we do that more? Just tell them to shut the fuck up. Stop being polite about it. My favorite part about Tim Walz is that he's a classic Midwest boy. And the Trump campaign tried to discredit him by pointing out the fact that he got a DUI in Nebraska. I'm going to repeat that. He tried to undermine his Midwest vote by pointing out that he drives drunk. That's all we do there. I did a Christmas bar crawl a couple years ago in South Dakota. All the bars were like 2 miles apart from each other. It was like 9 bars spread out over like a 9-mile course. And they're like, you're just going to have to figure out the logistics yourself. So it was just like a drunk relay race back and forth on the interstate. And they want us to hate a guy for getting caught doing it? No, that's enough of my political ranting. I wonder if you guys will get this one, too. My partner also introduced me to a show called Couples Therapy recently. Have you watched Couples Therapy? That's really good. It's a reality show featuring actual relationship counseling. It's just like recorded relationship counseling sessions. And they have a bunch of different couples. But my favorite, by far, is they have a 3-person polycule from Williamsburg, Brooklyn. And when they're like, we're a 3-person polycule, I was like, that's cute. Can you imagine what relationship counseling with a Richmond polycule would look like? It would look like a fucking TED Talk. It would be the first relationship session and require a microphone. Alright, statistically, at least one of you in here has to be in a Richmond polycule. Alright. I guess we're all good little monogamous Christian boys and girls in here. No, I don't have anything against polycules from a moral standpoint. But I will say, I don't understand how people do it. Because it's a lot of fucking logistics. It's a lot of planning and scheduling. It's like, I don't want to take something as fun as being in a relationship and make it feel more like my shift at Applebee's. If I was going to be in a polycule, I would have very specific requirements. There is a perfect situation in which I would be in a polycule. These are my requirements. I would have to have a goth girl. I'd have to have a redhead. I would have to have a black man. And I would have to have a green shapeshifter. And we'd live in a giant skyscraper shaped like a T and fight crime. That's the only situation I would ever be in a polycule. Alright, that's my time. I've been Kale Moore. Thank you guys.
Kale Moore, exactly 5 minutes on the dot. That's a goddamn professional, everybody. Give it up for Kale Moore. All right, we are down to the last few comedians of the night. We really do appreciate. Thank you, Bridget, for all your help. Give it. Make some noise for Bridget, everybody. All right, we love you. And thank you, Ash and Lainey, for staying. Y'all are fucking riding it out. You got a friend? What's your friend's name?
Anna. Oh, I'm Anna.
Anna. Hey, Anna. Everybody say, hey, Anna. Oh, right. Yes, this is our crowd. All of these are comedians, so we really appreciate you guys hanging out. I'm going to come get a wing. Guys, your next comic. Your next comic is no stranger to Home Sweet Home. This guy, he's hosted here before. He runs an open mic every Wednesday at Basic City. He's going to give you what you need. Give it over Tyler Bauer. What's up, Home Sweet Home? I'm trying to get a motherfucking kidney stone tonight. I'm trying to get motherfucking black psoriasis tonight. I'm trying to get juvenile hepatitis tonight. Let's get wild. Ooh, I got pills in my pocket. Hey. Who wants some prescription strength ibuprofen? We're getting wild tonight, Home Sweet Home. We're getting wild. We're getting crazy. Speaking of wild and crazy, who remembers, well, probably most of us weren't alive, Pee-wee Herman, he got caught in the 90s jacking off in a porn theater. Almost ruined his career. I think that's wild. That's what you're supposed to do in a porn theater. You're watching porn. You're supposed to jack off. What the fuck? That's bullshit what they did to my boy Pee-wee. Imagine you're jerking off in a porn theater, you turn to your right, it's Paul Rubens. That'd be exciting. You give him a little nod. Word of the day was come. I guess that's just what you got canceled for back then, just doing what you should do. Now people get canceled for good reasons. R. Kelly, great music, bad guy. I think if R. Kelly ever gets out of prison, he should open a pizzeria like a retired baseball player. At R. Kelly's pizzeria, all of the pizza is undercooked. It could be like a 72 part commercial called Trapped in the Walk-In. Hell yes. What? I have written down the R. Kelly version of Mr. Brightside. It was only some piss. How did it end up like this? It was only some piss. It was only some piss. I don't know. I think I'd make a great PR rep for celebrities, guys. Dave Grohl, for example, he got in some trouble a month or so ago having a child outside of his marriage. That's crazy. Well, Dave Grohl, 11 children outside of his marriage. I think if I was his PR rep, though, I would just make something worse to distract from that.
If I was Dave Grohl's PR rep, I'd just tell him to make a collab album with Kanye West. Call it the Jew Fighters. Thank you. People who survive suicide sometimes get a semicolon tattooed on their arm to, you know, show that there's still a continuation to the story. I'm going to get a question mark tattooed. You don't know if I'm still going to do it. I might still kill myself. I have a lot to live up to, too. My dad killed himself, actually. He jumped in front of a truck on the highway. Heart suicide to follow up, Dad. Now if I kill myself, I have to, like, get hit by two trucks, or, like... I have to put two guns to my head. What would be a creative way to kill myself, Patrick?
Get hit by a plane.
Getting hit by a plane would be hard to do. It would just be like when they fucking pulled out of Iraq. There's all the people that tried to jump on the planes, like on the landing wheels, and they just fell off. That's how I'm gonna go out. The old Iraqi hangman. Damn. It's okay. I know Sammy Tamimi. He'd like that. Anyway, he's a good guy. Imagine if Hitler had a man bun instead of that silly mustache. Because now, no one can wear that silly mustache now because of Hitler. Probably the best thing he did, you know, it looks a little stupid. But if if Hitler had a man bun, no one could have a man bun. And then you just have a bunch of hipsters running around Richmond with silly mustaches. I guess they already do run around with silly mustaches. Moving on. I'm trying to get motherfucking boils on my dick. Anyway, my friend said he didn't like watching horror movies because he doesn't like watching people die for no reason. Understandable, but I feel like horror movies do usually give a reason. It's not always a good one, but horror movies do give a reason. Yeah, horror movies will be like, he's a jock, kill him. Horror movies will be like, they're having sex, kill them. Horror movies will be like, he's black, kill him first. And that's fucked up. Horror movies are the devil. Robin Hood only stole from the rich because they had the most money, not for like a practical reason. You're not going to steal from poor people. There's nothing you can really steal from poor people. What are you going to steal, a 94 Toyota Celica? What are you gonna steal? A fucking jar of just pennies and nickels? It's also used as an ashtray? What are you gonna steal? A fucking Jack Daniels neon sign that hasn't lit up in years? Thank you. I've been Tyler Bauer. Y'all been great. We're gonna hand it back to your host, Patrick. Goodbye!
Tyler Bauer, everybody. All right. I do want to make an announcement, or this is a PSA. Is Ethan Halfhide at Home Sweet Home? Ethan Halfhide, going once, going twice. All right. He was on the list. I don't know who he is. All right. Ethan Halfhide's not here. Your next comic told me today, dude, I'm going up with no notes. And you might see him right now looking at his notes. Guys, I love this guy. Give it up for Zach Carpenter. Let's do it.
I don't know if you guys noticed, I'm just carrying this shirt. It's just my favorite shirt, that's why I'm carrying it around. I just like it. I don't know. I wore it yesterday and it doesn't fit anymore. I don't know why. I'm fucked up, guys. I don't give a fuck about anything. I don't give a fuck about shit at all. I don't give a fuck about shit. I'm just kidding. That's just a character I made up called the guy who doesn't give a fuck about shit. I hope it worked. I was watching, let me tell you something, Home Sweet Home. I was watching porn the other day, as one does. It was a threesome video, you know, and I started falling in love with the girl who wasn't getting as much attention as the other chick. I started saying shit during the video, like, oh my god, this guy isn't treating you good enough at all. I would treat you so much better than this. I have a lot of student loans, but we could figure it out. Me and you could run away together. And then I busted and I forgot about her. And that's the end of that joke. I was clean and sober for four months-ish. And then I relapsed, right? And I was pretty bummed out at myself about it, but I also like was like, oh shit, I remember why I like doing drugs so much. Because drugs feel good, right? You ever done drugs?
Woo!
I was asking you specifically, I didn't point at you, but... Yeah, I just can't do it too much, you know, because then I was telling myself, I was like, hey, Zach, you know, you can't take it too far. You're going to end up with your head in a fucking Denny's toilet again. That's a true story. It should be funny. That's not a joke. That's just an actual story. I can't drink that much, man. When I start drinking, I get into, that shit. I'm going to point at you and I'm going to ask you a question again. You know what I'm talking about. Crystal meth. I'm a crystal girly. I love crystals. I still have all my teeth though. I used to do a lot of meth. I still have all my teeth. And I wonder if other meth heads look at me and go, is this our messiah? I always wonder. I don't know. Yeah, I used to do meth. I used to smoke a lot of crack too. There's this funny thing about crack is like when you smoke crack, people don't like when you live in their house. They ask you to leave. I was living somewhere, I was smoking crack, and they were like, Zach, you can't live here anymore. And I was like, okay. And I was living somewhere else, smoking crack still, and they were like, you can't live here anymore either. And then I started living in my car, smoking crack, and they were like, sir, you can't live in your car on the street here anymore. That joke doesn't work. That's just another true story. It's just funny shit. I went to rehab recently, again, a second time, 6 months. I'm trying to break the record. That was supposed to be funny. Oh, shit. I got out, though. The day I got out was my cousin's engagement party, you know, and they had, like, a bunch of food and shit, and my cousin was like, are you doing all right? I'm like, yeah. As long as there's no crack cocaine at this party, I think I'll be okay. But these meatballs are pretty close. Some good meatballs, I don't know. Nothing comes close to the sweet taste of crack, though. I was just kidding. You guys have no idea. I don't know. Since I relapsed and fucked up my whole life and shit, I've been kind of bummed out, right? I've been all, like, depressed and suicidal and shit. But I'm like, I don't want to put any effort into, like, my depression and shit. So, like, I look up, like, how to tie a noose. It's like a 13-minute long YouTube video. I'm like, fuck that, dude. I'll find another way. I mean, you're just not even accounting for all the time I got to pause and actually try to tie the thing, you know? All right. That was supposed to be funny, but I've been Zach. Thanks.
Keep it going for Crack Carpenter. I mean, Zach Carpenter. No, my man. Zach, you're goddamn funny, dude. Keep doing stand-up, man. God damn it. All right. We are down to your last few comedians. But I forgot to try this joke, Zuri, when you were talking about spades. I thought of a joke, spades. You know what I love about spades? It's the black version of hearts. I thought that was good. It's cold in there?
Yeah, I'm gonna go downstairs. It's too cold.
This is me holding back and making a joke about it being cold and Sabet being here. All right. She liked it. All right, guys, your next comedian. She's a goddamn madman. She's off the fucking chain, guys. She's darts off the dartboard, guys. Let's give it up for Actually, I think I'm gonna, let's just wait. Let's just wait another 5 minutes. All right. No, let's give it up for Emily Erblin, everybody. The Dark Sith Lord, Emily Erblin.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you for your interest in the darkness. This is the interest meeting for joining the dark forces. Give it up for yourselves for coming out tonight. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I'll be your cruise captain this evening. My name is Emily. You guys, who's doing missionary? Proud. A proud hand shoots up. We're doing missionary over here. A shy hand. A glass. We're still doing missionary in 2024? Really? You can't force your religion on people. I, for one, never do missionary because I like authenticity, you know? I need them to accept my God as their God for me to come. Anyway. What's up? Missionary?
No, the one where they
turn on. Oh, missionaries. It's a play on words because a missionary is someone who, like, travels to spread their religion to others. It's all good. I also don't like missionary because you gotta look them in the fucking eyes. And I'm not about that. You know, I love you doesn't count in missionary. That's what God said, anyway. I've been thinking a lot about time. Time. And all the eras across history. And you know, like, why certain eras are called the way they're called. You know, like the Stone Age. I'd love to live in the Stone Age. I'm stoned right now. I'll light up any time. I'll live in the Stone Age. It sounds like it's for me. Or, you know, like the Bronze Age. I like fine jewelry. but I was thinking, you know, like what kind of age are we in now? What's going on now? How will tomorrow's students think about the 21st century? And what will they call our age? And I think they're going to be calling it the Goo Age. You guys ever watch Nickelodeon? What was up with all that slime? The war on oil. This century has been defined by sludges, goos, and slimes. Okay? For years, young women ran YouTube just slinging their immortality creams, their youth aiolis, okay? Think about how many fucking types of paint there are. Okay? You guys just wait, okay? In 10 years, or it's gonna be called the goo era. Okay. You guys just fucking wait. Let's see. I'm going through a breakup. But I'd way rather, break it down. Someone hit a beat. yeah, I'll get loose. I sell cheeseburgers. I sell hamburgers and cheeseburgers for a living. Give it up if you're a motherfucking American and you like hamburgers and cheeseburgers. Something we can all agree on. I sell hamburgers and cheeseburgers for a living. But I have beef with my customers. I have beef with my customers because sometimes my customers are like, Emily, I want my cheeseburger to be like no other cheeseburger. That cheeseburger better be one of a kind. It better be rare. And sometimes they're like, that cheeseburger better be a job well done. A plus. And sometimes they don't care. They're like, I want my burger right in the middle. which makes it complicated. Why, when I go back to the kitchen to retrieve the burgers, because the line cook, he looks at me and he's like, okay, that burger is a pleasure to have in class. It's well done. That burger is my dream girl. She's rare. And that burger is the medium. And I swear to God, I feel a cold breeze come into the room. And I feel a shiver down my spine. And I look at the line cook and I say, you're telling me that burger is a medium? You're telling me that cheeseburger can reach my grandfather? I have a message, please. Please. I totally date. These people over here are like, yeah, right? Yeah, right! I totally date. My first date, I had the same exact thought I had when I went to my first ever hardcore show in Richmond. I was like, there's a pit in here?
Oh!
Maybe that one's for print. Maybe that one's for a comic strip about dates. Can I tell one more? Okay, I'll tell one more. I'll tell you about my most recent relationship. This guy, he was a real film buff. You guys know what that means? Whenever we watched a movie, we had to be naked. He insisted on it. And he only liked horror movies. Horror Gone Wild, Horror Next Door, Two Horrors, One Cup, you know. But his favorite movie was The Thing. And he was like, Emily, it's really important to me that you see The Thing. And I said, I ain't no prude. I saw The Thing on our first date, you remember? And he was like, no, Emily, you don't understand. The Thing, it gets rave reviews from critics. And I said, shut the fuck up about your ex. I didn't ask. And, oh.
That's all right. We got a wreck. Do one more. Already found.
He was like, Emily, The Thing had the best special effects of all time. And I said, the special effects got in my eye, motherfucker. This is a play on words about a penis. Can you guys give it up for our lovely host and maid of honor, Patrick Logan?
Hey, I was gonna wipe it up for you, my lord. I love that Emily thinks she looks like a Sith Lord, but she really looks like Cruella de Vil. We got one left, all right. This is the most unchivalrous thing I've ever done, just watch a woman clean up her mess. It's funny to me, I'm sorry. All right, guys, we're down to your last few comics. Your next comic, she's got her coat on, she's ready. We're happy to have her, guys. Let's give it up one more time for Sabette Partey! Anyways, we've got two comedians left. They've been patiently waiting, guys. I'm excited to see them. Let's give it up for my man, Reggie, everybody.
How's everyone doing?
Good.
Hey. right back at you. I thought I was last. So you walked there, okay. Everybody ready for another 4 years of Trump?
Nope.
He's excited. Hopewell's excited. Excited. No, honestly, Biden actually got more of the black folk, did better with black too. Kamala, which is pretty shocking, you know. Kamala was so mad at black men, she went back to being Indian. And now, after spending $2 billion, close to $2 billion on her election, Kamala's now $20 million in debt. She's not black anymore, but her credit score is. Shouldn't have laughed at that. You failed the test. Everybody else passed. Black people have great credit. Trump just got a huge gift with Biden pardoning his son. I mean, just think about all the stuff Trump can pardon now. I mean, if you thought he was grabbing bitches by the pussy before, wait till he gets elected. We might have the first presidential white party in Mar-a-Lago now. Speaking of white parties, of course I have to talk about P. Diddy. I mean, I feel like there's a victim of P. Diddy that no one is talking about, which is all these babies that have had to go without moisturizer. Since P. Diddy's been in jail and all this baby oil has entered the economy, these babies are looking healthier and healthier. I mean, think about it. What good is baby formula when your baby's got dry skin and cracked lips? And another thing, you know, everyone's talking about P. Diddy's freak offs before he went in jail. No one's talking about his freak offs that he's having in jail right now. I mean, literally, from the jail bars to the stall, to the sweat drips off those balls, all those pussies crawl, all skisky fucker, all skisky goddamn. So P. Diddy's having a tough time. Biden's having a tough time. They actually try to blame Biden for inflation. I mean, you can't blame Biden for it. Inflation is because of all of us. We all want our little raise every year. They give you the raise in your salary, and then they raise the price on their products. Here's my solution to inflation. My feeling is we should just pay everybody less every year. Less and less and less and less and less. Until just before they bring back slavery. Then we'll cut it off right there. We'll stop right there. That's my solution. But, things are not as bad as they seem. They can be a lot worse. There's a show a buddy told me about called Summer House. Summer House is a show where privileged teens get together and talk about their trials and tribulations and first world problems. I don't want to hear that shit. Here, I've got an idea for a show. Crack House. Or Trap House. And my favorite, Dilapidated House. Now being produced in Churchill. And these houses in Churchill are just selling like hotcakes. I mean, they're on the market, they're off the market. That's my problem with gentrification. Not its impact on the community, per se, but its perception. The perception of gentrification is that black people can't afford these houses once they get renovated. We can afford these houses. The problem is, we remember when these houses were trap houses. And nobody wants to own Leroy's former trap house. Okay? One person left. And the other problem is Leroy could come back. It doesn't matter how well you renovate these houses, Leroy is gonna know every square inch of these houses. And we don't wanna wake up to Leroy in the kitchen cooking eggs and crack. Bacon and eggs is fine, but eggs with a side of crack is just not the same. All right, this is a problem with losing your spot. So, there's this rumor going around that Biden has been dead this whole time. Because he's taller than he used to be. Look, Biden has earned it. If Biden wants to be dead, let him be dead. If he wants to be taller, let him be taller. Me, I'm going another way. I say it's not good to be tall. You do not want to be tall. Being tall is like driving an SUV. You gotta worry about rollovers. Seems like every week I hit a corner too tight and bust my ass on the floor. You got your fuel efficiency sucks. Folks, after this set, I'm gonna have to get a Big Mac just to stay alive. And you gotta be concerned about pedestrians. I can't tell you how many people I've crushed and killed. Sorry to all my victims out there. Another problem being tall is, I got time for one more? Oh, okay. Another problem with being tall is, you constantly getting asked to get stuff off the top shelf. He's giving me a real weird ring. It's like, yes and no. You're always gonna be asked to get stuff off the top shelf, okay? Just the other week I was at a Walmart. In most cases, it's fine, actually. People, you know, that's easy. Just grab some on top shelf, it's nothing, right? But sometimes it gets out of hand. Last week I was at a Walmart. Lady asked me to get something off the top shelf. I said, sure, fine. Unless he just grabbed it. Then the lady asked me to get down on the ground. I was like, why do you need me to get down on the ground? She said, so I could climb up your shoulders and get the iron off the top shelf. I'm like, why do you? Ma'am, are you? You think I'm Jacob's ladder? All right, that's my set. That's it.
Keep it going for Reggie. Yes, being tall. Being tall is a gift and a curse. Being tall, I can reach anything in the house except for the back wall. Anything except for what you want me to reach. All right, anyways, guys. Are you ready for your last comedian of the night? Woo! You don't sound ready. You don't sound ready. Guys, we have a celebrity drop-in. She drops up, drops in, and goes up wherever she wants. It's last. She's been doing comedy a long fucking time. When I first got into the Richmond comedy scene, I was a little scared because she is a self-proclaimed militant feminist of comedy RVA. And I gotta tell you, she's not that bad. All right, guys, let's give it up for Kate Carroll, everybody!
Hello. Thank you for sticking through it all. You guys have a good evening tonight? Yeah, fuck yeah. I love that. No, this is one of my favorite open mics. I don't know. One of the things I consistently talk about or that I have been talking about over the time that I've been in comedy is it's been a very strange time to be alive. I mean, especially as like a woman, but also just as a person. I don't think that is just specific to me. But like... what I've noticed in particular lately is there have been a lot of sore winners running around. In particular, if you know what I'm talking about, if you haven't been blacked out for the last month like I have, just in sheer depression over everything that's going on, a certain person won, and Schmottle Schmump, and you know, I remember every time, like, a Democratic candidate won the presidency, and I remember the people that voted for that candidate never seemed to, like, gloat about it. Now, recently, I finally decided to do the thing where I downloaded TikTok, which I thought that I was not legally allowed to do that since I'm over the age of 35. But I downloaded it and I started, I was gonna do like a debate panel. And I ended up getting a lot of followers after that because I guess some people liked what I had said. Now, quite a few people didn't like what I had said and they found my Instagram and started trolling me. Now, one guy in particular that was trolling me the most, every single like video I'd made or any like post I'd ever made, I made a post about raising funds and like collecting donations to take down to like Southwest Virginia following Helene. And this guy literally commented, MAGA, 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 we're coming for you. You want pictures of dead Palestinian kids? Like, Jesus Christ, dude. Didn't y'all just fucking win? Like I don't understand why that is the psychology surrounding this. That's like if fucking Taylor Swift ran up and fucking interrupted Kanye. Like that's like it's like if Nancy Kerrigan broke Tanya Harding's knee. Like I'm like you guys won, dude. Like, just let us be, I guess. I don't know. It's fucking... I've been trying to engage more in that kind of, you know, discourse, but it's stressful because, you know, we all have lives to live and, you know, we all just want to kind of just exist happily and healthily and not have to do this shit. But, like, I'm starting to see it in every aspect of my life. Like, okay, so I got married a couple years ago and I'm still getting, like, ads for, like, you know... Because, you know, things that you would need for a wedding, like dresses or like flowers or photographers or things like that, or venues. And I still to this day am getting ads for plantation venues. I get the sense that everyone here is either from Richmond or has lived here long enough to understand what I'm talking about, in the sense that in the South, we don't really seem to have an issue with plantation venues as places to get married. I get it, they're beautiful. wonderful agriculture. But no, here's the thing, like, I don't think enough people really think about why that's such a bad thing to just ignore. Because in the South, like, let's be fucking real. Did everyone just, like, forget what happened between, like, 1860 to 1868? Did people just forget that that happened? Or did anyone forget what happened prior to that? Like, you mean the entirety of fucking American existence? Did we just forget that we had an entire population enslaved? Like, hopefully they didn't, but it does seem like a lot of people have. My point is, you know, in Germany, you're never going to see some prissy blonde German bitch turn to her best friend and be like, well, you know what? We really badly want to get married at Auschwitz this summer. But it was booked solid through the season. So we decided on Dachau instead. You know, it's a smaller venue, but you know, the vaulted ceilings are really beautiful and, you know, really to die for. I will leave you with this. My husband, who is seriously just most incredible person, I love him so much, but his father just so happens to be an alt-right Twitter personality. And that has resulted in some very interesting conversations. One in particular was when he dropped a hard R in front of me and then proceeded to get angry about the fact that there was a black mermaid. And I get it because it's slightly, this is a heavy concept, but I like asked him about it. I was like, why are you so pissed off about this? Like, how does this affect you negatively? He was like, well, I'm just mad that there's not enough representation for Appalachians. Sir, could you please explain to me how we would make the Little Mermaid Appalachian? What, is she gonna be fucking running goddamn moonshine and pulling copper out of her neighbor's walls? Like, do we have to make like Ursula the Mothman? Like, I don't know how. Anyway, that's my time. Thank you guys so much. I'm Kate. You guys have a great night.
Kate Carroll, everybody. Oh my gosh, that is the show. Thank you so much, you stuck to it. Everybody hung out, how cool. Jacob, it went well, it went excellent. You can come back to Home Sweet Home every first, third, and fifth Tuesday at 9 o'clock. If you want to follow more comedy in Richmond, Comedy RVA on Instagram. My name's Patrick Logan. Take care of each other, get home safe, and good night. Tip the bartender, and let's have a good night. Let's go smoke crack in the parking lot with Zach Carpenter. All right, that was Silver's idea. Good night.
Thanks, you guys. Let's see here. Get my little proper-oony. It's so heavy. You know, I'm gonna cut that bit, actually. Okay. Let's see. I worry that as a culture we're losing sight of the value of tradition. It's so important to carry on our traditions, or as I like to call them, pillars of community. My grandmother, actually, she was a cum slut whore, a sex worker. Yes, and my mother, she's a slut amateur, never went pro. But it's so important to carry on those family traditions, am I right? Keep the spirit of Christmas alive! My grandmother, Mai Bang Wai, she was from Vietnam, and in her village they called her the Mountain Woman because of her giant bazongas. Now, if we could all just take a moment and quietly to yourself, think of your grandmother's bazongas, regardless of size. If I were to follow my grandmother's footsteps, I could be like the Molehill Woman. Like the mountain, the molehill is another important natural landmark with a kind of understated elegance, I think. It's like that old saying, turn a mountain into a molehill. Oh no, sorry, it's turn a big titty into a small titty. A molehill, it's just some dirt, really. When a mole burrows close to the surface, he creates a kind of splash zone of earth. Terra. When you see a molehill, that means a mole is on the move. Catch sight of one of these old boys, that's a sign of moles on to greener pastures. someone did call me a whore once in high school, and you know, I love a sexually liberated woman as much as the next person, but I wore almost exclusively tea-length dresses, and I was considering joining a convent. Boys weren't giving me financial capital in exchange for my sexual skills. They were cheating off of me in Spanish class. I was very good at Spanish. And if your grandmother's in the sex trade, you learn a little something about abortion, okay? Or as we like to call it, flushing babies. It's okay, it's like fish. Babies can't swim, so. Being in the sex trade, though, in a colonized, war-torn nation, it can put a strain on a family. My grandmother, she had five children who made it to full term. And to give you a sense of how they're doing, my own mother recently sent me a Venmo request for $4 million. To give you a sense of my financial situation, I have obviously cut my own bangs. And sometimes you shouldn't cut corners, you know what I'm saying? if someone does call me a whore, though, it has a kind of a lore. Very biblical, very Mary Magdalene. It's like, what are you gonna throw a big rock at me? What are you gonna throw a big heavy rock at me? Whoop! It's like ancient dodgeball. Those rascals just looking to have a good time. You know what I mean? It's one of my kinks, though. I have a sexual chest of toys, and in my chest I keep a collection of papier-mâché rocks, hand-painted. And I'll have my sexual partners yell, whore, while pelting me with hand-painted rocks. I took such care with each one. And then I say, my community rejects me while desiring me at the same time. And then he says, shut up, slut. And then we end with what the French call a little death orgasm. I have a copy of Mary Magdalene's Gospel, obviously. And if you didn't know, Mary Magdalene, that's one of Jesus's closest buds. Around 590 AD, Pope Gregory says, you know, actually, Mary Magdalene, and she didn't have much interesting to say at all. Actually, big, big slut. And she just had a really nice, perky, small rack. And as the millennia passed, that's the headline that stuck. Mary Magdalene's big whore and Jesus loves small tits. Thank you so much, everybody.
Megan Richards, everybody. All right, good night. I'm meeting this time. Good night. Good night, Emily. Good night, Reggie. Good night, Zeri. All right, we're done.